Very interesting and important table. Now that the peace negotiation started, and they hope to finish it next year, and no doubt if the pressure of Obama and Kerry and the European will be strong over Israel, they will have to come to such kind of agreement, which very likely will not be so satisfying Israel, but under this pressure, they will have to do it. If not, the whole nations, all worlds will be against them. So we don't know. Only we are looking in the book Deuteronomy, which against our thousand, to see where the words Eskem HaShalom, which is really means the agreement of peace, will coming, in what are the verses, what is the location. And then we were amazed to see that it came really in a place that also a long time ago, in the agreement with Oslo, I think it was Professor Sam, who found it coming the same places. Now what is written here, this is really a little bit frightening, but who knows? You know, everything in the Torah is free choice. Torah tells you all possibilities. Now, let us see what you have here and really what we are really learning from these verses. So the first thing, as I told you, we are looking for the best meaning of the word Eskem. In Hebrew is Eskem. You can see Eskem HaShalom. This is the best meaning in Deuteronomy against our thousands. We said, according to Vilna Gaon, this thousand is against this book. Then we were amazed to see that it appears here, this is really the minimal in the whole Torah, every 10 letters, skip, Betav Shin Ayin Dalet. Tav Shin Ayin Dalet, this is really next year, which in a non-Jewish man can be 13 or 14. And what is also interesting, that you have here really a prophecy in the Torah to the Ador Acharon, to the last generation, exactly apparently where we are now. So the Torah tells us in the last generation might be pain, perhaps there is a people by you, Yishuisha, a man, family, or a group, a party. Levavo pone ayom, meim Hashem, the tan for she, their heart turned away from God, and they say, carries on, Litbach Belavo will say in his heart, yeah, we'll have peace. Ki beshirut libi alech, and I will do what I want to, really. We'll do things which I like to do, definitely it is against the Torah, and this is what will bring strong wrath and anger from God, definitely. Want peace. And Netanyahu comes also here, by the way, you see Netanyahu coming here. So, really, such a situation that tribes, parties think, yeah, we'll have peace, we'll enjoy ourselves, we'll have a good life. God says, it will not be like this, what you want. And the continuation here that God will be angry with them and troubles will come. Now, as I told you, that such a situation after the big pressure of Kerry and Obama, which both appears here, you can see Obama coming here, this last generation, no doubts they will put a lot of pressure on Israel, and who knows what the result will be. And it is interesting, as I told you, that the word Oslo comes here, because the same situation was in Oslo also. Now, what we have here, really a danger. Unfortunately, it's more than a threatening, but almost telling you, if you be like this, you will turn away from Torah, from God, then it's Shema Shema Al Admatchem. God will uproot you, like did this in Gush Katif, in this place, in other places. Yeah, he will uproot you with anger, yeah. Strong growth, it's an important message. If you don't keep Torah, turn away. But then you will realize when all these things, Yabo Lecha, Kol HaDvarim Ha'ele, when all these things will happen to you, blessing and curses, for one side, Israel successfully growing, and Klala, but curse also, as we see now, so this is what will be coming afterwards, Vashivot Elevavcha, you will think in your heart, what is going on with this situation that we are in. Enger, Ross, Obama, Kerry, and peace agreement. We don't know if it will happen, but as we said, that if this table really shows that this is what we're going to happen, so no doubt, similar to Oslo, can be lots of problems. But if we do tshuva, we come back to the Torah, definitely these things will not happen. As we see clearly, it's all these verses say that such situation will develop when you turn away from God, from Torah, from mitzvot. So let us hope that really this year, Tavshin Ayin Daled, next year, will be a year that will do tshuva v'shevota, and will really get rid of those terrible dangers that look to be after this pressure of the world, Obama, and Kerry. So let us hope this month of Elul, important month to do tshuva, also important for Netanyahu to do it, to know it and to do the tshuva, and then we'll have quickly and speedily redemption in our time.